prepare to fail, when you fail to prepare. These are two values that Postmaster imbues in us right from our origins. Preparation and practice. So we'll begin our Toastmasters meeting today with the prepared speeches round. Our first prepared speaker of the day is Toastmaster Vishal, and he's being evaluated by Toastmaster Amjad. So may I have Toastmaster Amjad read out the objective of the speech?
The objective of the speech is to begin speaking before an audience to discover speaking skill you already have and skill that needs some attention. Time for the speech is 4 to 6 minutes.
Thank you. Thank you, Postmaster Amjad. Before I call on our next speaker on the stage, I'd like to tell you a little thing about me, about him that he told me a couple of days back. He told me that his biggest passion in life is to earn money. Money is something which I personally dread. So when I come across somebody who wants to earn a lot of money, I am amazed and inspired, because it is one of my biggest fears, money. The money, I believe, will consume people and make things out of them which they never started out being. However, this speaker gave me an interesting twist to the entire thing of wanting to earn money. He said money is important. Striving to earn money is also very important. It is important to even take risks, but not do so at the cost of earning greed. Earn money, but don't earn greed. Please join me in welcoming Toastmaster Vishal as he commences his journey to Toastmaster.
Master of the day, fellow Toastmasters, and dear guests. Why do changes take place? Why can't things be the way they are? Are changes a way of life? I bet this is how you would think if you lived in three different countries, two different states of India, changed four schools, changed six houses in the first 20 years of your life. Well, I was born in Muscat, Oman, near 1993, in a Gujarati family. I don't remember much about Muscat because by the age of three, I shifted to Mumbai. And unfortunately, after that, I've never been to Muscat. In Mumbai, my life didn't last long. 4 years I shifted to Bahrain, where I spent the major part of my childhood. Bahrain is a small island in the Middle East. Whose population is less than the population of the western suburbs in Mumbai. It's known for its pearls, culture and tradition. It was a peaceful and a beautiful country until political turmoil took place. I spent 8 years of my life in Bahrain. And I fell in love with the country. This was a country which houses my most favorite memories. My dad is a production engineer and he still works in Bahrain. My mom is a housewife and they both are born and brought up in Mumbai, so basically I'm from Mumbai. Also, I have a younger brother who just finished his 12th grade and is studying commerce. My parents are liberal. They've always encouraged me to try out new things. They've always given me the space to make my own decisions, learn from the mistakes, make mistakes and learn from them. Even though I spent 8 years in Bahrain, I celebrated all the festivals in Bahrain. In fact, firecrackers are banned in Bahrain, but we bought them illegally to celebrate Diwali. During my summer vacations, I used to come to India to visit historic and religious places. And I did my schooling in a CBSE school, so this kept the Indian in me alive. And I played a lot of cricket during my school life. At the age of 12, I represented a Bahrain cricket team in the under 15 level, under 15 World Cup for non-test playing countries. And this was the place where I earned my first salary. And this has been the biggest achievement of my school life. In academics, initially I was not that interested, but in 8th when I was introduced to the Newton laws and physics, I really started liking my subject. And I realized that I have a knack for understanding complicated problems, or thinking about them and solving them. And I was also inspired by my dad, who is a production engineer. So I decided to pursue engineering. After 10th, I took a very bold decision to go to Kota, Rajasthan, which is the hub of IIT Delhi Coaching. I thought that if I want to do something, let me try for the best. so the first time I was alone, completely alone by myself, but things didn't work out the way they must have. I felt like a fish taken from the pond and dropped in the ocean. I couldn't take up the pressure and the competition in Kota. I was not used to this environment where people started for competition rather than learning and enjoying the subject. As expected, I didn't do well in my exams, but fortunately, I got admission into DJ Samani College of Engineering, Vilayapalle. And the plus point of my failure was that I got my desired field of mechanical engineering. I do not regret my decision to go to Kota because this has taught me the meaning of struggle, determination, and a change. This also helped me to understand what it means to have a dream and to execute a dream. So again I shift to Mumbai, to the place where I belong. Life in the first, I'm right now in my second year. Initially, life was not that easy. I was still coping up with my failure in Kota, and on the other hand, trying to catch up with the pace of Mumbai. As I was used to the slow life in Warren and slow life in Kota. But by the second year, I was almost a Mumbai. I'm almost a Mumbai, and I've again found my passion in my studies. And my mission of my life right now is just to make myself stronger in all aspects of life, physical, mental, morally, so that I can take up all the challenges and be successful in them. So I would end by answering my own question. Change takes place because change is a bait to a better life. Change is a nature's way of telling us that nature's way to improve our life. We do not have the control of the changes taking place in our life, but we do have a control to make